Hi, welcome to Aerotech Solutions. We discussed about embedded system introduction. So as of you know, so you have very good ideas and very good demo sessions in our internet source. Like, I want to wish myself, so just follow this introduction of embedded systems, what I described. This is my view of embedded system. So we designed the complete embedded course in three levels. One is firmware, and the second thing is Internet of Things, and third one is Global Professional. This firmware module, which includes C and DS with strong fundamental and logical skills with the C language with Linux platform and embedded C, and we have 8-bit and 16-bit target boards with all communication protocols knowledge. And the second level of embedded system, we describe like Python as a language, and we have 32-bit target boards, either LPC series or Raspberry Pi, so STM32. There are three different category boards we have. And the third level is Global Professional, which has the highest demand in the market, which includes Linux system programming, kernel programming, and device drivers with a BeagleBone target board we are implementing. So this is the three level of embedded system course we designed based on freshers and 1+ experience or 2+ experience or 3+ experience people, so they can choose their choice. Otherwise, you can complete the three level training and you can get very good placement in embedded market. So we are located in Housing Board from Hyderabad, very near to JNTU University, Kukatpally. So this is why my general electronic system, which a combination of multiple inputs and multiple outputs. So you want to define your electronic system, so it's a combination of software and hardware which performs various and multiple functionalities decided by engineer. So based on a requirement of application, you need to design your system with different input combinations and different output combinations. Your input combinations may be simple buttons, switches, or keypads, or keyboards, or sensors, or card reader, or modules. Anything should be your input for your system. And what kind of general output devices you can find from your application point of view. So there are display system is like one common thing you can find from your electronic system. As a display, you can find indicators or text display screens like LCD screens, or numbers displays like 7-segment. And then audio videos, like audio should be your output or video should be your output of your system. And electrical loads, maybe motors or modems. These are all different categories you can find from your electronic system as an input and output point of view to solve your application or to finish your product. Any electronic product may be combination of these input and output combinations. Then, so who will take care of this input, and it is going to monitor or control your output. So as a system, if you look out the hardware board, you can find multiple components in the board. There are ICs, resistors, capacitors. There are different devices in the electronic hardware board. But from that hardware point of view, which are the major components you need to learn? I think as an electronics engineer, you can know what is that component, either resistor or diode or capacitor or IC. So something you can identify, okay, this is the resistor or this is the IC. But among those electronic component, which is the major device? So which one has the highest, which one has the take most responsibility in your system? Like You can compare your electronic system like a general human body activities, like how the human body functionality, which is purely depends on brain signals. So anyway, your brain will sense the smell through nose, through ears it can see, like, so there are different parts which are working in a human body. The same way, the electronic system, you are replacing a human being is doing some work. So that human being activity you are doing with electronic system nowadays. Then, so it means your electronic system also required some intelligence. Your electronic system also required some brain. So that brain, maybe your processor, or it is a controller, or it is a DSP processor, or it is a FPGA, or it is a PLC. So as of electronic students, they maybe know these names: microprocessors, microcontrollers, digital signal processors, field programmable gate arrays, and programmable logic controllers. These are the five list of programmable devices. They can know the importance of all these devices from your system. But then what about the other components? These other components are also very important to the system, but the entire process, which is the entire controlling and monitoring or processing your inputs and giving your signals to output side, these are all entire process done through this intelligent device. So that's why this is a very important device from your hardware point of view. Then how to talk with this device? Then how I can assign my work with this electronic device? So as an engineer, you're working with these programmable devices in electronics. You should approach with these devices with a specific language. So what language they follows? They have their own unique languages. Like if you check out microprocessors and microcontrollers, they will accept your commands, they will accept your instructions through a specific language, which is C or assembly. So that's why every electronic system is a combination of software and hardware. So that software may be here, it's a language or it's a program. The program, how you are going to develop? Through language. So until unless you are not aware of language skills, it is not possible to finish your program. So then what about hardware? So whatever the components you are connecting around your intelligent device, that complete part, that complete circuit will become the hardware part. But so you want to make sure all these individual activities of your individual components through your intelligent device, you need to pass some commands. So that commands, maybe you should write in a specific language here. For your microprocessors and microcontrollers, you need to write your commands through C or ASM. So this combination will make you, this combination application maybe comes under embedded system. So you want to tell one electronic system, it is an embedded product or it is an embedded system, that system has to develop with microprocessors or controllers with a specific language, C or ASM. But these devices which are updated now, they are in very advanced stage with respect to processors, with respect to language categories. And what about DSP system? So this DSP system, which is designed with digital signal processor as an intelligent device and MATLAB is a programming language. And how we are going to construct one VLSI system, you need to know as a device FPGA knowledge is more, and as a language you should understand Verilog or VHDL. So and what about automation platform, which needs the knowledge from engineer, programmable logic controllers and ladder logics. So from here, every domain has its own language and devices. So that combination will make you perfect in that specific domain. You want to become embedded engineer, you should approach with the languages like C, C++ and advancements, whatever you are finding from C language. And about devices, you should approach, there are different category families in the market, 8-bit families, 16-bit families, 32-bit families and 64-bit family devices. So that combination will make you very good, perfect engineer in that particular platform. And you want to become DSP engineer, go with this MATLAB and DSP combination. And you want to become VLSI engineer, go with this Verilog or VHDL and FPGA device skills. And you want to become automation engineer, go with this PLC and ladder logic combination. This is my just brief information about different platforms in the electronics. See, all are electronics, don't worry about this. You can choose any platform to grow in your respective fields. So as an embedded, you need to most concentrate on C skills now and microprocessors and microcontrollers. So as my part, I'm entering into this specific zone, embedded. So we are in embedded system training from last 10 years. So we are more focusing on language. That too, which language you are taking here? C. With C language, you are giving training on more passionate, and you are giving very good programming skills, and typical interview point of view questions you are covering, and you are giving more assignments on this. So that will make you very strengthened person in that language part. And devices. So you are dealing with different families here, 8-bit families like 8051 boards and Arduino boards and PIC microcontroller boards and Raspberry Pi boards, which is 32-bit family, and LPC families and STM and BeagleBone. These are all different category boards here. Now you are more stretching here, you are entering into embedded domain. See, the simple electronic system design by using processor. So how can you construct a simple electronic system by using processor? So as a processor, how it deals with this, how can you connect your input and output combinations? So your processor, it doesn't take your direct input from your input devices. You know that already. Inputs means what you can connect with your electronic system: sensors, keyboard, keypads, modules, RFID card readers, or any device. And coming to output side, you can connect multiple displays, motors, audio video devices. There are many, but the processor won't allow to connect input and output devices directly, because so it cannot take data directly from your input devices. It always needs the information in zeros and ones. So here, these zeros and ones information which allows always, and it gives output also in zeros and ones format, so that you need one more device in between input and processor, and again processor and output. So what kind of devices I can place in between input and processor, and processor and output? Between input and processor, people will use generally programmable peripheral interface. So what is the purpose of this PPI here, which will allows IO ports to connect your input and output devices? These IO ports which will help us to connect inputs and outputs. And what is the use of memory here? Whatever the program you are writing, whatever the commands you are writing, so this allows to store program. So this is a simple electronic system design by using processor. So these processors are introduced by Intel Corporation in 1971 with a 4-bit capacity. So this means, what is the meaning of always people will talk the processors in bit capacities? First thing is, first introduced processor which has 4-bit capacity, means which allows only 4 binary inputs at a time, and it gives 4 binary outputs. And next, they introduced next bit capacity device, which is 8-bit, and I think which is most of the engineers from academic point of view, they know this 8085. And whereas 8086 is a 16-bit processor, 86, 186, 286, 386, and there is a 32-bit processor, which are all Pentium processors, which is used more processors which are used in 1990s to 2000. So they used these Pentium version processors in all computers. There are 64-bit processors which are more running in market now, with all I-series processors. This is the evolution of processors, but any application you are developing with processor, you need this PPI support and memory support from externally. So you need to connect all these components individually, whereas any electronic system design which considers three important parameters: cost, size, and power consumption. So this cost, size, and power consumption are the important parameters to design any electronic system. So you want to achieve these three from electronic system point of view, you should more concentrate on, whereas processors, you are going to connect externally all these devices with processor so that cost estimation may be high. So further, they are going to introduce, or so they did, this Intel Corporation did again introduced one more device by integrating all these things on a single chip. That's maybe your controller. But any embedded system or any embedded application specific characteristics, they have their, it has to follow its own characteristics. If you check out any electronic system which is developed under embedded platform, that should be combination of software and hardware, and the functionality of the system which is predefined by the engineer, and it has to work 365 days 24/7, and it cannot be reprogrammable by the end user. He has to use that set. So most of the embedded applications you are finding in daily life in all sectors, medical and consumer, robotics, displays, transportation, defense, radar, there are many more applications in many more areas. So this kind of electronic system you want to design, the controllers are better choice in embedded platform. So what this controller, and this is incorporated with processor, memory and IO ports, the integration of all these things on a single chip. And again, this is also introduced by Intel Corporation. They introduced first 8-bit families and 16 and 32. So these are the different generations which are running in the market now, and there are so many areas you are using these controllers and processors. Consumer electronics, automotive, communication, medical, office, these are all different areas where you can find this. See, televisions, calculators, refrigerators, washing machine, n number of applications you're using in our daily life. These are all comes under embedded stream because of this hardware and software combination. So these are many more applications on locking systems. And see, daily life, walkie-talkies, which is in telecom, and fax, computers, networking device, routers, switches, and there are many more tracking applications, GPS, so which are using in transport area, and RFID, POS, point of sale, barcode readers in retail market. This is comes under defense. And so these are all different applications from different categories. And why you need to choose this embedded technology? So why many more companies which are engaged with this embedded technology? Because you want to make the system very compact in size. Anyway, I already said you need to concentrate on size and power consumption and cost. So these are all the three major categories you need to concentrate on this embedded technology. There are standalone devices, network, mobile, real time. So this is the simple overview of embedded domain. Like, you want to reach us, this is our address. So we are located in Hyderabad near JNTU KPHP metro station. There you can find the route, so which is very near to JNTU metro station, around 200 meters to 300 meters. It's a walkable distance from KPHP metro station to our office. Thanks for watching.